नमस्कार, फिर पैसा बोलता है में आपका स्वागत है। मैं आनंद श्रीनिवासन, वेलकम बैक टू पैसा बोलता है। वी टीच यू हाउ टू मेक मनी टॉक। आई बीन रनिंग अ तमिल चैनल वेरी सक्सेसफुली फॉर द लास्ट 4 years। वी आर नियरली हैविंग अ मिलियन फॉलोअर्स देयर। मोस्ट ऑफ यू वॉन्टेड द सेम कंटेंट इन इंग्लिश बिकॉज दिस डज नॉट गो बियॉन्ड तमिल पॉपुलेशन। I did have a Hindi channel. I did not find editors who could speak Hindi fluently, and therefore we had to switch this to an English channel. We have an English channel which does international business. So I thought we will do Indian stuff here. The idea today is to talk about a stock which has hit a new 52-week high. The stock in question is an ITC. The question of ITC today is at 398 per stock. This is a new 52-week high, and I expect it to hit 400 as quickly as tomorrow if there is no major global headwinds tonight. But this stock nearly for a long time was valuing less than 200 rupees. I kept recommending this stock from 180. It dropped all the way to 134 and then has bounced back. At all times, it gave us time for 2 years to accumulate this stock. Not many did. There were a lot of stories saying that the ECG governance was bad, the company had to be split into two, the company is not giving enough money back to the shareholders. All sorts of stories and inventions were made. The point is very simple. Money was available freely. Money was chasing other stocks which were not considered harmful, because especially foreign institutional investors consider cigarette stocks as sin stocks. So they are not big stockholders of ITC, and mutual funds were not buying ITC because they had to show returns and they were buying stocks which the foreigners were buying. The idea in value investment and the idea in contrarian investing is always to buy what the market does not like. When we looked at ITC and did a checklist of all the important parameters, ITC looked very good to be true. I asked and I urged everybody to keep piling on into ITC. At one point, I was trolled badly in the net, and then ITC turned around. When it turned around, it took off like a rocket, and today it's at 398 rupees. But things had got so bad that the chairman Sanjeev Puri had to come out and run an investors day to assuage investors. Investors got so cocky that they were demanding that the board spin off the IT company separately. ITC does have an IT company which does not surface very largely into the numbers because it's too small. But I suspect it does nearly $1 billion year in revenue. ITC has many divisions, cigarettes being the main. It has a huge FMCG component. It has a hotel business. It has agriculture and it has paper. And apart from other small businesses such as IT, which I have been talking about. In revenues, cigarette constitutes about 40% of its revenue. But more importantly, it contributes nearly 80% to its profits. And that cigarette is the main backbone of ITC, because there cannot be any competition to ITC in cigarettes because the anti-smoking laws have been tightened over the period of years, which means foreign brands cannot invest in India and grow this market. And it is very difficult for a new player to beat ITC in terms of marketing and advertising spend, which ITC has done for more than 100 years in India. ITC has also been very defensive. It has blocked its parent, British American Tobacco, from playing a major role in ITC. It's capped its stock holding at 29%. The government has been the largest shareholder. The government also has been selling its stake, and therefore there was a fall in ITC share price. All that is beyond us today. ITC has taken all the money it has made in cigarettes and invested in various sectors which I listed out just now. It is hoping to become the top three players in FMCG and also in agri. It's really moved to number three position in biscuits. It has a very strong presence in the noodles market. These are markets which are dominated by Nestle and Britannia. And it has almost caught up with Parley using Sunfeast as a brand. It has sources agriculture produce from the farmers, uses a unique system called eChopal, where transparent price discovery is given to the farmer. It picks up from the farmer, does agri trading in exports internationally, and also packages and brands it in, sells it to consumers. Agri, therefore, is 21% of this company. It is not only agri trading that is important, it also feeds into FMCG products. That is, better sourcing of agri products means cheaper FMCG for ITC. ITC has gained market share in FMCG, but its margins are in deep single digits. It's not yet gone to double digits, but over a period of time, it will definitely increase it to double digit. when we last known figure on the Infotech was that it is 2,900 crores. But people tell me inside from ITC, it's much bigger than that. From February 23, it has given 6 dividends. May 22 was the last dividend of 6.25 rupees. It has given 3 bonuses, 2005, 1:2, 2010, 1:1, and 2016, 1:2. The stock was split from face value of 10 to 1 in 2005. So the idea is very clear that let us not go back too much in history and look at a time of 2020, May 8th, when the stock was trading at 158, and I have been talking about it, and you can verify it in my channel. If you had put in 1 lakh rupees, on May 8, 2020, you would have bought 633 shares. And today it is trading at 398 rupees. And therefore the stock would be worth 2,51,934 rupees. In terms of dividend, you would have received 24,308. The total return on ITC today is 2,76,242 rupees. This includes the principal you have put of 1 lakh. So your net profit is 1,76,242. Even if you had put on a bank FD, which was actually at 5% at that time, but I'll be generous and give you 7% return, you would have made 1,23,144. So this 23,144 is lower than the dividend of 24,308. This is much better. I am not even looking at the returns you have made in the stock. This is only the beginning. ITC has a long way to go because over a period of time, subject to the fact that it does not need money for further investment, it will give away 75 to 80%, at times even 85% of its profits as dividends. So you can expect the dividend stream to grow over a period of time. It has also said that it will continue to aggressively invest in all its FMCG business and grow it bigger. In a matter of 20 years from today, if you look at with an aspect of long term, ITC after HUL will become one of the biggest FMCG players. In terms of food, it will be bigger than Nestle or Britannia. This means that if you are buying this stock cheap even today, I'm not suggesting that you rush in and buy. The markets have buoyed up the stock, hoping a great result in the month of May. Analysts are talking about results, but ITC normally is a very late presenter of results. So you can expect it only in the second or third week of May. All you can expect now is speculation. If the results disappoint, you will see a correction in ITC stock and it would be a right time to enter. You can always sip in ITC stocks. The idea of my philosophy of investing is this: buy large cap high quality stocks when nobody wants it. Like Warren Buffett says, you buy when the street doesn't like it and you sell when the street loves it. In case of ITC, we too love ITC and we don't want to sell it. Thank you for watching Paisa Bolta Hai. If you like this video, hit the like button of this video and press the subscribe button of my channel. Turn on the bell notification. If you do not turn on the bell notification, you will not be notified every time we put out a video. It is better that you remain notified. Kindly share this video with your friends and relatives and have them take a look. Thank you for supporting Paisa Bolta Hai.